Welcome to the MEP Academy. We're going to cover the refrigeration cycle and the four major components, including the basics of heat transfer. We'll quickly go over the refrigeration cycle, and then we'll cover the individual components and the physics behind it later. But real quickly, you have four components. The number one is the compressor. That's what is the heart of the system. It takes low pressure gas and pumps it up to a higher temperature and higher pressure gas. The gas flows along this line over to the condenser, where the gas is condensed into liquid. It gives up its heat to the outside air. This is where you'll find a condenser outdoors. This is an air-cooled condenser. It's cooled by the air, so the gas condenses into a liquid. So you don't see these dots anymore. This gas represents gas. So this is liquid now going through the tubes. And you gotta have liquid when you get to your metering device. So this controls the high pressure and a low pressure liquid. So you got high pressure liquid coming in, low pressure liquid coming out. Now this liquid is going to boil. It's going to take the heat from the room and boil. So the heat will make the refrigerant boil and turn back into a gas. And then the gas will make its way back to the compressor, and that's one complete cycle. High pressure gas to high pressure liquid to low pressure liquid to low pressure gas. That's the complete cycle. Now heat flow. Heat flows from warmer medium to cooler medium. It always flows in one direction, from the warmer to the colder. To understand the compressor, you'll need to understand the relationship between temperature and pressure. It's very simple, as they act in the same direction in the refrigeration cycle. If you increase the pressure, then the temperature also increases. That's what the compressor does. It raises the pressure of the vapor from the low side to the high side. The same is true if you decrease the pressure. The temperature also decreases. Pressure and temperature move in the same direction like a one-way highway sign. In the refrigerant cycle, we have the high side and the low side. Okay, one more simple explanation about physics before we move on, and that is the phases of refrigerant. So you're familiar with water, so water has three phases. You have the solid phase, which is ice. You have the liquid phase, which is water, and you have the gas phase, which is vapor. So in the refrigeration cycle, you only have two of these phases. That is liquid and gas. We never get to solid. If you get to solid, you got a problem. So you only have liquid and gas in the refrigeration cycle. And this refrigeration cycle is a continuous changing of the state of the refrigerant from gas to liquid, and then liquid back to gas over and over again in the process while moving heat around. There's basically only four conditions you'll find in the refrigeration cycle. You're either going to have high pressure gas, high pressure liquid, low pressure liquid, or low pressure gas. Now, what you will find, besides these four, is that as the liquid is evaporating or condensing, you'll have a mixture of both liquid and gas. But by the time you get to the compressor, it has to be all gas. The compressor only deals with gas. And by the time you get to the metering device, you should be all high pressure liquid. Subscribe for additional videos. We will be covering mechanical, electrical, and plumbing estimating, engineering, installation and fabrication best practices for mostly commercial construction and some residential.